This is the schema that we will create by using Java code from consumer. In the previous lecture, we create another dummy consumer.java while we don't have queue to listen. In this lecture, we will learn how to create exchange, queues, and bindings from consumer side. We can create the schema on rapid listener annotation. Make sure the exchange and queue does not exist, and then head back to another dummy consumer.java. We can declare RapidMQ schema from RapidListener annotation by using variable bindings instead of queues. This variable takes special annotations at queue binding, which has annotation at queue and exchange in it. It is a little complicated. Personally, I'd prefer the previous alternative by using configuration class, but let's see it in action. Okay, I will remove the queues variable. And replace it with bindings. We have add queue binding annotation first. Then we will have variable value with annotation at queue. I will give the queue name queue.autodummy and durable is true. For the exchange, we use variable exchange and annotation at exchange. In this case, I will create x.autodummy with type direct and durable is true. Since this is a direct exchange, we need a routing key, which we can declare on variable key. Set the ignore declaration exceptions as true. Wow, that is a long statement and need to careful with all parentheses and comma. But we are done. Let's run the consumer project and check RapidMQ. As we can see on RapidMQ, we have the expected output on queues, exchange, and bindings. If you need any help on syntax on how create RapidMQ schema from Java code, please see this lecture resource. I provide sample code that you can use. Okay, let's move to next lecture. But before that, I will delete the exchange and queues used so we can start fresh. See you in the next lecture.